Well, it's July the 23rd, Wednesday, and it's a boiling hot day. It's 28 degrees here, and it's 6:30. It's ridiculous. And as I was walking across the field, having looked at the river, I was followed by a pheasant. I thought it maybe thought I had some food, because it just followed me within about 3 feet. Next thing I know, it jumped up and attacked me. And it wouldn't be put off. You couldn't chase it away. It went 2 or 3 feet and that was it. And it was at it again. And it followed me all the way back up to the car and was on the road anyway. The blooming thing is here again. I don't trust it an inch. It's been attacked by this pheasant. Bloody thing. I don't know why, I haven't a clue. But it's just about 6 goes at me. Oh, yeah, bloody nuisance it is. Watch it. You get close to it, it's toxic. It's gone. It jumps up and claws you. Pecks you. Well, here's his pheasant back again. He's got a really long beak. There's no tail feather. It's a cock pheasant. I don't know what it's about. Not just a blooming thing, one iota. What's going to do? I'm going to have to give it a clatter with my newspaper for a minute. It won't be put up. I know what the... Hopefully when I let it out it goes away. Well, I've just come down to fish on the swale. It's Friday the 25th, and it's now 5 to 7. And I've just bumped into another angler who's been who's been set about by this pheasant. It really is a vicious thing. If you're sitting in your seat and it jumps up with its feet flailing and its beak flying, it could really damage your eyes, let alone scratch your face. Anyway, when I went to look for it, it wasn't there, but I've just heard it now. It's back again. So what he'll do about it, I don't know. Anyway, it's been another glorious day, and it's wonderful now as well. It's a summer. This summer has just been outstanding. But again, we haven't had any rain for, well, certainly... where I live for 6 weeks now. So I'll just sit back and enjoy it. It's such a shame not to be on the bank. Let's just get this whole business about lighting videoing and night fishing into perspective, I think. It's the 26th of July, and the lighting up time here is 21:16, which is basically 9:15. Just a little explanation about light, video, and impressions of night. Sunset tonight here was 21:16. It's the 26th of July 2014, and so basically 9:15, and it's now 9:45. As you can see now, turn the watcher off the right way. It's not easy. And this is the light as it appears naturally. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to switch the video projector light on, the camcorder light on, so you can see it without me in the picture. So there you can see the light on the camcorder. Now when I step round in front of this to make a video of myself, I just want you to look at what happens to the background, which would be exactly the same on the riverbank, but of course I'm doing this in my garden. So I come round to the front. I stand in front of the video camera and just look at the background. The background's like night. Let me just switch the light off. So there you can see it as it actually is at 9:45. So I'll just switch that on again. So there I am. Same time, 46 minutes past 9, which is 14 minutes to 10. And the background's like dark. Now if I just walk out of the picture, so you can't see me. There you see it without me. I just walk back in. Now you can see it with me in it. Well, I just hope that that goes some way to explaining why it might seem like people are on the bank in the middle of the night, when in actual fact they're not. I hope that just gives you some idea of the effect of light. When you get a very bright foreground, the background just becomes dark. Try it yourself. You can do it with a simple camera with flash. Anyway, take care. Good night. Well, it's Sunday, the 27th of July. And again, another wonderful day. Fortunately, not quite as hot, but still, down here out of the breeze, it is remarkably warm, and it's 6:15. Anyway, it's very, very quiet, and there's a multitude of pegs to choose, so just sort of meander up and down the bank. The nice thing about this time of year is, and when the water's quite clear and slow moving, is you can see all these big snags in the water, which of course later in the year, when there's a bit of turbidity in the water and it's piling through a bit, then it puts you in a better place when you hook a fish. Anyway, the rods are ready, and I'll put them in and just settle back for probably get about 4 or 5 hours in. Wonderful.
wonderful looking fish from the front. But isn't that sad? It's lost half its tail. It's all healed up, but it's a sad sight. And similarly, this dolphin is a bit torn at the front there. It's just tragic. For a fish with only half a tail, it put up half a fight.